Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to show you how to use Excel to calculate the area of a circle. So by the end of this video, we are going to show you how you can put the radius of the circle in cell A2 and have cell B2 automatically calculate the area for you.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So as we all know, the area of a circle is equal to pi r squared. So if I want to follow that formula here, I'm going to click in cell B2, and I'm going to type an equal sign. And Excel has a built-in function, and it's called pi. And if I put a left parenthesis and then a right parenthesis, and I hit enter, I can see that I am getting 3.14. But Excel doesn't just make pi to be 3.14. If I go up to the home ribbon, and I expand my number of decimal places, I can see that pi is calculating out a lot further. And I believe that pi in Excel goes out to about 15 decimal places. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. But let's click back up here in the formula bar. So now that we know that Excel can calculate pi, we need to compensate for the rest, which is r squared. So I'm just going to type an asterisk for multiplication. If you hold down shift, it's the sign above the 8 key on your keyboard. And then I'm going to click in A2 to get my radius for R. And then for squared, I'm going to hold down shift and the 6 key, so I get this little caret and a 2. And if I look at my formula right here, I can see that this is pi. A2 is representing my R. And to the second power right here is representing the squared. So if I hit enter, I am now getting an area of 28.27, which is correct, because if I look at the radius in A2, it's a 3. So if I square that, that's 9. And if I multiply it by pi, it's 27 if I round pi to 3, but I can see where the 28 is coming in for the 0.14. So we have a couple other ways that you can calculate the area of a circle out on our blog. I'm going to include the link to this blog entry in the description below on YouTube, so feel free to visit there and learn a little bit more about the area of a circle. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.